Hello students, welcome to Neja Akshara Academy YouTube channel. In this session, I am going to discuss work, energy and power, problems on power, part 3. If you like this video, please like, share and subscribe to our channel. Please share your valuable comments in the comment section. Okay, let us go to the today's session, problems on power, first question. A motor boat is going in a river with a velocity v bar is equals to 4 I cap minus 2 j cap plus k cap meters per second. If the resisting force due to stream is f bar is equals to 5 I cap minus 10 j cap plus 6 k cap newtons, then the power of motor boat is. Here in this question we have to calculate power of motor boat. Now let us go to the solution. They given V bar is equals to 4 I cap minus 2 J cap plus K cap, and F bar they given as 5 I cap minus 10 J cap plus 6 k cap. Now power P is equals to F bar dot product of V bar. So that is equals to F they given as 5 I cap minus 10 j cap plus 6 k cap dot product of 4 I cap minus 2 j cap plus k cap. Here dot product of I dot I 1, J dot J 1 and K dot K 1. 5 4 za 20 minus into minus plus 10 2 za 20. Here dot product of J dot J 1, 10 2 za 20 minus 10 into minus 2 minus minus plus. So 10 2 za 20 plus 6 1 ja 6. So 20 plus 20 40 plus 6 46. So power of the motor boat is equals to, we are getting 46 watts. So therefore P is equals to, we are getting 46 watts. Okay. Now we'll go to the next question. A machine gun fires 420 bullets per minute. The velocity of each bullet is 300 meters per second and mass of each bullet is 1 gram. The power of the machine gun is. Here we have to calculate power of the machine gun. Now let us go to the solution. They given number of bullets. Here a machine gun fires number of bullets 420 per minute. So N is equals to 420. And T they given as 1 minute, converting into seconds 60 seconds. So V is equals to, they given as each, the velocity of each bullet is 300 meters per second. Mass of each bullet is 1 gram, converting into kilogram 10 to the power of minus 3 kilogram. Now we have to calculate power of the machine gun. Now P is equals to, the rate of doing power is known as, the rate of doing work is known as power. So P is equals to W by T. So that is equals to N of half M V square by T. So P is equals to N M V square by 2 T. So this can be written as P is equals to N M V square by 2 T. Now substituting values, N they given as 420 into 10 to the power of minus 3. Here the into 300 V square, nothing but 300 into 300. So by 2 into time they given as 60 seconds. So that is equals to here 0 and 0, 6 वन जा सिक्स, सिक्स सेवन जा 42, जीरो एंड हियर टू वन्स टू 150 जा, सो नो लास्ट वी आर गेटिंग हियर 10 टू द पावर ऑफ माइनस 3, हियर 10 एंड हियर 0 एंड हियर 0, टोटल कैंसिल, सो 7 इंटू 10, 70 का मेंटेनेंस 10 एंड 10 टू द पावर ऑफ माइनस 3 एंड 15 इंटू 3 इंटू 10, दिस वन एंड दिस वन, हियर 150 इंटू 10, सो नाउ दिस कैन बी रिटन एज 150, 115 इंटू 10 एंड 3 इंटू 10, हियर 10 वन कैंसिल, दिस एंड दिस एंड दिस कैंसिल, सो वी आर गेटिंग 15 थ्री जा 45, सो 7 इंटू 45, सो पी इज इक्वल्स टू 7 इंटू 45, वी आर गेटिंग 315 वाट्स, सो दिस इज द फाइनल आंसर, सो देर फोर पी इज इक्वल्स टू पावर इज इक्वल्स टू 315 वाट्स. ओके नाउ नेक्स्ट विल गो टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. If the power of the motor of a water pump is 3 kilowatts, then the volume of water in liters then that can be lifted to a height of 10 meters in 1 minute by the pump is. Here we have to calculate the volume of water in liters. Now let us go to the solution. Here they given P is equals to 3 kilowatts. This can be written as 3 into 10 cube watts. So now we have to calculate volume of water and they given as h height 10 meters and t is equals to per minute nothing but 60 seconds, rho that is 10 cube density of water 10 cube kilogram per meter cube and g is equals to 10 meters per second square. We have to calculate the volume of water V. Now the P is equals to W by T, that is equals to M G H by T. So that is equals to, they can be written as mass. So m is equals to density is equals to mass by volume. Mass is equals to density into volume into g into h by t. Here since rho is equals to m by v, so m is equals to rho into v. We are substituting in the place of m rho into v. So p is equals to, we are getting rho v g h by t. From this we are writing the formula for volume of water. V is equals to, taking cross multiplication, p into t by rho g h. So p into t by rho g h. Now we are substituting the values, then v is equals to P nothing but they given as 3 into 3 kilowatts converting into watts, 3 into 10 cube into 60 by 10 cube into 10 into 10. So 10 cube 10 cube gets cancels, 0 0 gets cancels, 3 6 are 18, 18 by 10. So this can be written as 1.8 meter cube. So V is equals to, we are getting 1.8 meter cube. Here 1 liter is equals to 10 to the power of minus 3 meter cube. So 1 meter cube is equals to 10 cube liters. So we are writing in this volume of water in liters 1.8 into 10 cube liters. So totally volume of water V is equals to 1800 liters. This is the final answer. Therefore, V is equals to 1800 liters. This is the final answer. Okay. Next, we'll go to the next question. A machine rated as 150 watts changes the velocity of a 10 kilogram mass from 4 meter per second to 10 meter per second in 4 seconds. The efficiency of the machine is nearly. Here we have to calculate efficiency of the machine. Now let us go to the solution. Given P input power P is equals to 150 watts and they given mass M is equals to 10 kilogram and V1 is equals to 4 meters per second and V2 is equals to they given as 10 meters per second and time in 4 seconds. Now we have to calculate efficiency eta. So efficiency eta is equals to output power by input power, P out by P in. So that is equals to W by T by P in. So this can be written as efficiency eta is equals to W by T can be written as half M V2 square minus V1 square by so T into here P input. Now we are substituting the values, then eta is equals to efficiency is equals to 1 by 2 into M they given as 100 10 square minus 4 square that is V2 square minus V1 square by P input they given as 150 into time 4 seconds. So efficiency eta is equals to here 0 gets cancels 10 square nothing but 100 minus 4 square 16 by 4 2's are 8. 8 into 15. So this implies efficiency eta is equals to 100 minus 16 84 by 8 into 15. Taking cancellation here 4 2's and 4 2's are 8, 4 1's are 4. So efficiency eta is equals to we are getting 21 by 30. So this implies efficiency eta is equals to 0.7. Percentage efficiency is equals to 0.7 into 100. So the finally we are getting 70%. This is the final answer. So percentage efficiency eta is equals to 70%. Okay. Next we'll go to the next question. A pump is required to lift 600 kilogram of water per minute from a well 25 meters deep and to eject it with a speed of 50 meters per second. The power required to perform the above task is. Here we have to calculate the required power. Now let us go to the solution. The given M is equals to 600 kilogram and T is equals to per minute they given converting into second 60 seconds and they given height 25 meters and V they given as 50 meters per second and G is equals to 10 meters per second square. We have to calculate required power. So P is equals to W1 plus W2 by T. So that is equals to P is equals to MGH plus half MV square by T. Now substituting the values P is equals to here MGH nothing but they given as 600 into 10 into 25 plus half MV square half into 600 into V nothing but they given as 50 whole square. So 50 into 50 by T nothing but in minute converting into second 60 seconds. So P is equals to here 2 1s 2 300s 2 3 6 0 0. So here we are getting 150 into 10 cube. So 150 into 10 cube into 300 into 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4 zeros. So 3, 5 is a 15. Now we are doing division. 150 into 10 cube plus 300 plus 50 into 50, 2500 by 60. So okay, now we are writing this 25 into here into not plus. This is into divided by 150 into 10 cube plus 300 into here 50 into 50, 2500 by 60. Now next P is equals to we are writing 150 into 150 into 10 cube plus 25 threes are 75. So this can be written as 750 into 10 cube by time 60 seconds. So P is equals to taking 10 cube as a common. So 150 plus 750 into 10 cube by 60. So P is equals to the required power. P is equals to 150 plus 750 900 by 60 into 10 cube. 0 0 gets cancelled. 6 1 6 15. So P is equals to we are getting 15 into 10 cube watt. In terms of kilowatts, P is equals to 15 kilowatts. This is the required power. So therefore, P is equals to 15 kilowatts. Okay. Next, we'll go to the next question. An electric fan with effective area of cross section A accelerates air of density rho to a speed v. The power needed for this process is here we have to calculate power in this process. So now let us go to the solution. So we have to calculate the power needed for this process. So the given area is equals to A and the given density as rho and the given speed is equals to V. Now next P is equals to W by T. So that is equals to K into E, that is kinetic energy by T. So that is half m V square by T. So this is can be written as half into m nothing but rho into V. So this is V square. So here m nothing but rho is equals to mass per unit volume. So from this m is equals to rho into V. This V represents the volume. Okay. Now so P is equals to half into rho into volume nothing but here we are writing A into L by L into V square. This V nothing but speed, this V volume. So here A into L by here L, this we are writing volume nothing but A into L. This T we are writing here L by T. Now this P is equals to now we are writing half rho A into length by time. So this is distance by time. Distance by time is nothing but speed. Speed is equals to distance by time. So this also is equals to V. V into V square, V cube. This is the formula for power. So power needed for this process P is equals to half rho A into V cube. Okay. Now next we'll go to the next question. A car drives along a straight level, frictionless road by an engine delivering constant power, then velocity is directly proportional to. Now let us go to the solution. P is equals to, they given as here, P is equals to constant, and so power P is equals to F into V. From Newton's second law of motion, F nothing but ma into V. So that is equals to A nothing but change in velocity by time taken, dv by dt into v. So here P is equals to, this can be written as v dv is equals to, v dv is equals to, this can be written as P by m into dt. Now we are doing this integration, then integration of 0 to v, v dv is equals to P by m integration of 0 to t dt. So that is equals to, now we are doing integration of x dx, x power n nothing but x power n plus 1 by n plus 1. So v square by 2 with limits 0 to v. So that is equals to P by m into t with integration of dt t. So with the limits 0 to t. So now v square by 2 is equals to P t by m. So this implies we are getting v square is equals to, taking cross multiplication, 2pt by m. So v is equals to, square is going to become under root 2pt by m. So this implies this v is directly proportional to root t, or this t to the power of 1 by 2. This is the final answer. Okay, next we'll go to the next question. Power supplied to a particle of mass 2 kg varies with the time as P is equals to 3 t square by 2 watts. Here t is in seconds. If the velocity of particle at t is equals to 0 is v is equals to 0. The velocity of particle at time t is equals to 2 will be, here they given as velocity of the particle at t is equal to 0, v is equals to 0. And we have to calculate velocity of the particle at t is equals to 2 seconds. Now let us go to the solution. Here they given P is equals to 3 t square by 2 watts. At t is equal to 0, they given as V is equal to 0. At t is equals to 2 seconds, we have to calculate velocity of the particle. Now P is equals to 3 t square by 2 watts. This is unit watts. So P nothing but F into V is equals to 3 by 2 into t square. So F nothing but, from Newton's second law of motion, ma into V is equals to 3 by 2 into t square. Next, can be written as m into dv by dt into v is equals to 3 by 2 t square. So this taking cross multiplication, 2m into here 2 into mv into dv. So here 2 into vdv is equals to 3 by 2 into t square into dt. Now here v dv is equals to m nothing but, we are substituting, they given as m is equals to 2. So 2 into, taking cross multiplication, v dv is equals to 3 by 2 into t square into dt. Now here v dv is equals to, v dv is equals to 2 into 2, 3 by 4 3 by 4 into t square into dt. So now we are taking integration of 0 to v, v dv is equals to 3 by 4 into t square into dt, taking integration with limits 0 to 2. So now integration of v dv nothing but v square by 2 of with limits 0 to v is equals to 3 by 4 with limits here integration of t square dt nothing but x square into dx to the power of n into dx x to the power of n plus 1 by n plus 1. So t cube by 3 with limits 0 to 2. So that implies applying the limits v square by 2 is equals to 3 by 4 into, now applying the limits and substituting the values here, this 2 into 2 cube. 2 cube nothing, in the place of t we are applying the limits. So 2 cube by 3, 3 3 gets cancels, v square is equals to here 2 ones 2 twos, here it is 2 cube, 1 2 gets cancels. So t square is equals to 2 square, here remaining 2 square, 2 square nothing but 4. So this implies v is equals to, we are getting root 4 nothing but 2. So v is equals to 2 meters per second. So the finally we are getting answer, therefore v is equals to 2 meters per second. This is the final answer. Okay, next we'll go to the next question. A constant power p is supplied to a particle of mass m. The distance traveled by the particle when its velocity increases from v1 to v2 is, here we have to neglect the friction they given. Now we have to calculate distance traveled by the particle when its velocity increases from v1 to v2. Now let us go to the solution. Here they given constant power, so p is equals to constant, and they given mass as m, mass is equals to m, and we are increasing velocity from v1 to v2. Now we have to calculate distance traveled, s. So p is equals to f into v. So that implies p is equals to f nothing but ma into v. So p is equals to m, acceleration can be written as dv by dt into v. So again this can be written as dv by ds into ds by dt into v. So that is equals to ds by dt, displacement by time gives the velocity. Next p is equals to, so p is equals to m into dv by ds into ds by nothing but v, and again v into v. So this p by m into ds is equals to v into v, v square into dv. Now we are applying the limits doing integration 0 to s, p by m into ds is equals to integration of from v1 to v2 v square into dv. Now p by m nothing but constant, integration of 0 to s ds is equals to integration of v1 to v2 v square into dv. So here p by m into integration of ds, s limits 0 to s, so that is equals to v square nothing but v cube by 3, applying the limits v1 to v2. Now we are writing this p by s is equals to, that is p by m of s nothing but, now we are writing p by m into, applying the limits s is equals to 1 by 3 into, Here applying the limits v2 cube by minus v1 cube. So from this s is equals to distance traveled s is equals to m by 3p of v2 cube minus v1 cube. This is the final answer. Okay, therefore s is equals to distance traveled is equals to m by 3p v2 cube minus v1 cube. Okay, next we'll go to the next question. A body is moved from rest along a straight line by a machine delivering constant power. The ratio of displacement and velocity varies with the time t is. Here we have to calculate ratio of displacement and velocity. Now let us go to the solution. Here v is directly proportional to t power half and s is directly proportional to t to the power of 3 by 2. When p is equals to constant, this is p is constant. Now we have to calculate ratio of displacement and velocity. S by v is directly proportional to t to the power of 3 by 2 and t to the power of 1 by 2, and it is directly proportional to, this can be written as S by v is proportional to t to the power of 3 by 2 into t to the power of minus 1 by 2. So this s by v is proportional to, here 3 by 2 minus 1 by 2, 3 by 2 minus 1 by 2. So this can be written as s by v is directly proportional to, taking LCM, 3 minus 1, 2 by 2. 2 by 2, nothing but 1. So this implies S by V is directly proportional to T. So as S by V is proportional to T, from S by V versus T graph, so this is the graph along a straight line. This graph behaves, this is the straight line. Here we are taking t, and here on the y axis we are taking s by v. This is the origin, and this graph behaves as a straight line. So s by v versus t graph is a straight line. So s by v versus S by V versus T graph is a straight line passing through the origin. Is a straight line passing through the origin. This is the S by, the ratio of displacement and velocity is directly proportional to T. Okay. Next we'll go to the next question. Power applied to a particle varies with time as P is equals to 3t square minus 2t plus 1 watts, where t is in seconds. The change in kinetic energy between t is equals to 2 seconds and t is equals to 4 seconds is. Now we have to calculate change in its kinetic energy. Now let us go to the solution. Here they given p is equals to 3t square minus 2t plus 1. Here they given as t is equals to 2 seconds. And t1 is equals to 2 seconds and t2 is equals to 4 seconds. Now change in its kinetic energy is delta ke. So that is delta ke is equals to integration of t1 to t2 p dt. So that is equals to, they given as integration of 2 to 4 t is equals to 2 seconds to tau is equals to 4 seconds. They given as p 3t square minus 2t plus 1 into dt. Now delta k e is equals to change in kinetic energy is equals to, so delta k e is equals to integration of 2 to 4 3t square, separating the constant 3 into t square into dt minus 2 into integration of 2 to 4 t dt plus integration of 2 to 4 dt. So change in kinetic energy delta k is equals to 3 into t square nothing but t cube by 3, applying the limits t to 4 minus 2 into integration of t dt t square by 2, limits 2 to 4 plus integration of t integration of dt t limits 2 to 4. So delta ke is equals to change in kinetic energy is equals to, here 3 gets cancels, now here also 2 gets cancels. Now applying the limits 4 t cube nothing but 4 cube minus 2 cube of minus of 4 square minus 2 square, and here 4 minus 2, so that is equals to 4 cube nothing but 64 minus 8 minus of 4 square nothing but 16 minus 4, so here 16 minus 2 square 4, 16 minus 4 plus 4 minus 2, 2. So delta k, change in kinetic energy delta k is equals to 64 minus 8 56 minus 12 plus 2. So that is equals to change in kinetic energy delta k is equals to minus 12, here 56 plus 2 58, 58 minus 12, that implies 46 joules. So therefore the change in kinetic energy delta k is equals to, we are getting final answer 46 joules. Okay, now next we'll go to the next question. In a hydropower project, 2000 kilogram of water passes through turbine every second. Water is falling from a height of 240 meters above the ground. If the power output is 3.6 megawatts, the efficiency of the powerhouse is, they given G as 10 meters per second square. We have to calculate the efficiency of the powerhouse. Now let us go to the solution. They given here mass is equals to 2000 kilogram and T they given as 1 second and height they given as 240 meters and power output power they given as 3.6 megawatts. So this converting into watts, P out is equals to output power is equals to 3.6 into 10 to the power of 6 watts. Now we have to calculate the efficiency of the powerhouse. So efficiency is equals to output power by input power. So that is equals to output power by input power nothing but mgh by t into 100. Now we are substituting the values. Efficiency is equals to p output power they given as 3.6 into 10 to the power of 6 into here into 100 by mgh, m nothing but 2 into 2000 kilometers, 2 into 10 cube, g nothing but 10 and h 240 meters by t nothing but 1. So t value 1, so that is efficiency is equals to here 10 cube, here 10 Now, first we'll cancel 2 ones to 1.8 ja 3.6. So, 1.8 into 10 to the power of 6 into here 100 by here 10 cube into 10 into 240. So now here we are writing here that is equals to here 10 to the power of 6, nothing but 10 to the power of here 10 square 8 0 0 gets cancels, this 0 get cancels here 1.8 nothing but decimal representation 18 by 10 into 10 to the power of 6 here this 10 cube here we are writing by 24 10 cube into 10 10 to the power of 4 so this efficiency can be written as this is 10 cube into 24 so 18 by 24 into here 10 to the power of 6 here 10 to the power of 4 so this can be cancelled so efficiency eta is equals to 18 by 24 into here the remaining is 10 square 10 square nothing but 100 so efficiency eta is equals to 18 by 24 we are getting 0.75 into 100 so the final answer efficiency eta is equals to we are getting 0.75 into 100 nothing but 75%. This is the final answer. Okay, thanks for watching this video.